to my channel. Today I'm going to solve a numerical on heat transfer from extended surfaces, which is also called as fins. We'll see what is a fin. In the study of heat transfer, fins are surfaces that extend from an object to increase the rate of heat transfer to the environment by increasing the convection value. The amount of conduction, convection, or radiation of an object determines the amount of heat it transfers to the environment. Increasing the temperature gradient. Temperature gradient means the difference of temperature. So, between the object and the environment, which means say if the object is at some higher temperature T1 and the environment is cooler as compared to the object temperature, say it is T2. So, the difference between the temperature T1 and T2 will be called as temperature gradient. So, increasing the temperature gradient between the object and the environment, increasing the convection heat transfer coefficient, which is the value H, or increasing the surface area of the object increases the heat transfer. This is self-explanatory. Sometimes it is not feasible to change the first two options because of economical reason. Say you cannot change the material, so you cannot change the value of heat transfer coefficient, or you cannot change the difference of temperature between the object and the environment. So in that case, one option or one solution is going to be changing the surface area of the object. So what we do is we are going to add some extra surface to the body so that it is an economical solution and the heat transfer problems can be easily solved. I'll show you some types of extended surfaces or fins. You can see over here. The first one is called as rectangular fin. It is also called as straight fin of uniform cross section. The second one is a straight fin, but it has a non-uniform cross-section. You can see it is a tapered fin. The third fin which you see is an annular fin. The rectangular fin is generally used in compressors, IC engines, and annular fin is basically used in heat exchangers. The fourth type which you see over here is a pin fin. A pin fin basically means something which is very thin and extending out of the body. So it's of the shape of a or the cross section is very small, like a pin. So it's called as a pin fin. And the fifth one which you see over here is a radial fin. Radial fin has many applications. It is used for transfer of heat in compressors or heat exchangers, or it is used in the radiators of IC engine. So these are some applications. The rectangular fin which I have shown you is also used in the compressor of the refrigerator. Now, there is another type which is called as heat sinks. I'll go for a numerical on this. This is how heat sink looks like. And heat sinks are generally used, say, at the end of computers, on the computer body. It is used for losing more amount of heat to the environment, where one or two surfaces, extended surfaces, do not help. Many surfaces are given in a small area or in a small dimension so that more heat can be lost to the environment. Here are some applications. So, I have already shown you the diagrams and I have given you some applications. You can still read over here. They are most commonly used in heat exchanging devices such as radiators of car, computer CPU heat sinks are used. There is heat exchangers in the power plant, wherein also the fins are used. They are used in newer technologies such as hydrogen fuel cells. This is a very latest technology in which the fins are used for losing the heat to the environment. Now, one interesting application which I have brought for you is nature has taken advantage of this fin. There are two animals you can see in the figure. The first one is a jackrabbit, which lives in the American desert, and the second one is a fennec fox, which lives in Sahara desert. So, since these animals live in desert, the body gets heated up more. So, to lose the heat from the blood, the ears have been modified over ages such that they lose more heat from these ears. So, they are kind of extended surfaces, fins as you would call them. So this is another application of fins in the animal kingdom. So this is all about the basics of fin. I'll start with the first numerical today. We'll go to ANSYS, steady state thermal analysis. This is example 6 of thermal. I'll go to geometry, right click, new design modular geometry. Today I'm going to solve the first type of fin that you have seen, which is a rectangular fin. Over the next few sessions, you will see the other types of fins which I'll be solving. I'll go to units, millimeter, x, y, look at. I'll go to sketching. I'll draw a rectangle. This will be my wall. I'll give it some dimensions. Say 100 by 80. I'll extrude the wall. Apply. Say I'll extrude up to 20. Generate. I'll select this face. New plane. Generate. I'll click on look at. I'll go to sketching. I'll draw a rectangle. I'm drawing a rectangular fin. I'll extrude it. Apply. Say I'm going to extrude it for 100 mm. Generate. So this is the wall and this is the fin. Now for the fin, I'll not do add material. I'll do add frozen. Generate. So you can clearly see over here. This is my wall behind and this is my fin. I'll go to model and double click on it. I'll first align my body. I'll go to geometry. The first solid is say structural steel. For the second one, I'll choose some other material. I'll go to new material. Okay. I'll go to engineering data sources, general materials. Say I choose the material as stainless steel. You can choose any other material or as per the project that you're solving, I'll update project. I'll double click on mod again. Second solid, I'll choose as stainless steel. You can choose any other material. You could have taken aluminium alloy or anything. In the upcoming problems, I'll choose some different material. I'll go to mesh, sizing, coarse. I'll change it to fine, update. I'll go to analysis settings. I'll choose the wall surface. I'll give it some temperature. I'll insert temperature. I'll change the units to degree Celsius. Say the wall is at 1000 degree Celsius. In the fin surface, I will have, and I'll go to steady state thermal, insert. I'll give convection. The coefficient value I'll give as 10 and I'll choose this entire body over here, apply. So this entire fin is subjected to some convection value. I'll give one more temperature value at this end. Say the temperature is 27 degrees Celsius. I'll go to solution and solve. Right click on solution, insert thermal, temperature. I'll solve it again. I'll change the value of convection coefficient to 0.01. So you can see over here, this is the temperature profile over the body, and this is my heat flux over the body. If I want, I can change this temperature to 1500 and check the solution. I'll just see the temperature. So you can just change the value of temperature and you'll get variable values of heat flux and temperature change over the body. The reason why you're seeing a lot of blue color in this is because the length of the fin is too long as compared to the requirement. So you can just shorten the fin as per its application or the temperature value that you have chosen. So this is how you solve the problem of fin analysis. I hope you have understood the numerical. If you have any doubts, do let me know in the comment section. I'll see you in the next session with another numerical of fin analysis. Thank you.